Now the third one is personification. Personification says it is again these metaphor and personification are closely related and they are most commonly used already too. So personification is a figure of speech where non-living things or non-living objects are described to seem like people. You know, where non-living things are given, are compared, giving human characters, human qualities. So this is a comparison where you're comparing non-living things with a living thing. The living thing, living qualities of a creature, of a person or a human being has been compared with a non-living thing. Personification gives human characters and qualities such as emotions, desires, sensation, you know, qualities of speech, often by way of a metaphor. So basically what you are doing is that you are giving human, you are comparing human qualities. Let's say for example something, one of the strongest gifts that God has given us and we are different from other living or things is our emotions, you know. We have, God has gifted us as human beings, we have a better way of expressing. It's not that other living animals are dead. They also have emotions. But because we can express it by our speech, by our, you know, actions and all that, so we are in a better position than animals. So that is when you are comparing. And when you are comparing these qualities with a non-living thing, that is personification. Understand? I'll give you an example then maybe. Let's say for example, if I say lightning. Danced across the sky. So dancing is a quality that we, you know, when like human beings are fond of. So the dancing quality of a living creature or humans has been, we are not talking about living creatures means all the animals and others. This is only the qualities of human beings, okay, has been compared with one of the natural elements of nature called lightning. So this is personification. Other example is, I'll give you one more example. So if you are asking me sometimes, how can you identify between metaphor and a personification? This will be a commonly asked question and something that will, some of you may be thinking about it when I'm talking, is that the situation where the author describes something non-human has been compared with a human character. A non-human character has been compared with a human character. You should understand its personification. Okay, this is one of the easiest ways to explain. Let's say, for example, if I say, I was eating a cherry pie or a cherry cake, and the last piece of cherry was calling me to eat it. All of the last piece of cherry pie or cherry cake was calling me to eat it. So we know that cakes cannot call you, or edible things cannot call you. But what I have done is that I have tried to inculcate the human qualities of urging, of calling, understand, with a non-living thing, that is personification. Understand? Okay.